Does anyone out there remember Bazooka Bubblegum?
These are two vintage printer sheets of Bazooka Joe Bubblegum comic wrappers. They came to us in very poor condition. Watch how we restored them today on Poster Fix.
We used to blow bubbles with this gum, right? It had a comic strip with it. Anyway, today we're going to linen back two uncut sheets from Bazooka Joe. This is what the wrappers look like. The wrapper of the gum and the comic strip were all one piece of paper. The paper is about this big, but this sheet has, you know, like 100 of them on the sheet at once, and you're going to see that getting linen back today. Take a look.
I've got two of these bubblegum wrapper printer sheets, and I'm going to open up the later one from 1955 first.
An uncut printer sheet of the comic strip that came with the bubblegum. It's so many strips on it, too. And then there's this damage here in the folds. The paper is very thin and brittle, dry. So we've got to linen back this to hold it together. There's more separation here. But this is the biggest damage here. So we're going to linen back this, and then we're going to linen back this other one, which we'll look at later. We're going to linen back this, but first I have to prepare a screen. This is a stretcher screen already stretched with canvas. I have to mount acid-free paper to it. So now I've got this acid-free paper down on the canvas, and I'm pushing out the excess air pockets to prepare it to receive the Bazooka Joe sheet. Okay, we've got the screen all prepared for Bazooka Joe. Now I have to carry this thing over to that screen. Nice. I think I'm going to apply the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper. Trying to spread the wheat paste very generously across the screen so that I can then lay the poster down on top of it. Since the paper is so thin, it'll probably absorb the wheat paste pretty well. Gently pushing out air pockets, the big ones anyway.
Bazooka Bubblegum was first marketed shortly after World War II in the U.S. by the Topps Company of, you guessed it, Brooklyn, New York. Yay, Brooklyn! The gum was probably named after the rocket-propelled weapon developed by the U.S. Army during the war, which itself was named after a musical instrument.
The water. This will help it expand. I'm spraying distilled water to the poster to help it expand, and it will also help the wheat paste to get pulled into the poster and well absorbed.
The bubble gum was packaged in a red, white, and blue color scheme and originally sold for 1 penny. Beginning in 1953, Topps changed the packaging to include small comic strips with the gum featuring the character Bazooka Joe. There are over 1,535 different Bazooka Joe comic strip wrappers to collect. Also, on the comic strip is an offer for a premium and a fortune. Older Bazooka Joe comic strips were larger in size and are no longer available. In addition to original, Topps eventually included the flavors Strawberry Shake, Cherry Berry, Watermelon Whirl, and Grape Rage.
This paper has a tendency to be very stretchy. It
wants to expand more and more. So I have to make sure that I roll it out in a way that helps it to expand in all directions evenly. This is much trickier paper than I get normally with vintage posters. And usually in my videos I speed up the action, but I think today, because of the enormous care I have to take in this rolling process, I would show it to you in real time. Maybe I'll speed it up sometimes. Like now. Hey, I'm going fast.
Yeah.
The only thing I didn't speed up was the soundtrack, actually. Boy, it seems to have expanded pretty good. Seems to be stretching out well. I'm using my regular traditional wheat paste mixture. I'm not using potato starch this time. I only use that with glossy posters. I've learned that the wheat paste is better, generally stronger, but the potato starch is useful to mix in with the wheat paste when doing glossy posters. And I think it's because the potato starch is thinner and it fills up the pores.
Bazooka Bubblegum also makes sugar-free flavors such as Original and a Flavor Blast's variety claimed to have a longer-lasting, more intense taste. Bazooka Bubblegum comes in two different sizes. Bazooka Bubblegum is sold in many countries, often with Bazooka Joe comic strips translated to the local language. Bazooka Gum is sold in Canada, with cartoons in both English and French, depending upon the city. In Israel, it is manufactured under license by Elite in the company's factory in Nof HaGalil. The cartoons are written in Hebrew. In Spain, it was sold under the name Chicle Bazooka, with only one O. Starting in the mid-1960s and featuring the Bazooka Joe strips, one of the publicity slogans was Chicle, Bazooka, Siempre en la Boca, which means bazooka gum, always in the mouth. Rhymes were a popular publicity trick at the time.
So I'm looking it over to see if there are any little pieces of paper that need to be flipped, but it seems to be all okay. So this first one is linen-backed. Now the second one. If I remember correctly, one of these sheets was in worse condition than the other one, and I'm not sure which one is which in terms of which one was in worse condition. Take a look at this Bazooka Joe. This is the first Bazooka Joe comic. Hi folks, my name is Bazooka Joe, and I'd like you to meet my gang. We have lots of fun all the time, and if you want to see what I'm talking about, it's easy. We'll all be in the Bazooka comics from now on. And it comes from a sheet of Uncut Bazooka Joe comic strips. You'll see us linen back this soon. In this original Uncut sheet, we're introduced to all the characters. Janet's my name, and I think Bazooka Joe is the cutest boy in the world. Sarge. Bazooka Joe and his friends call me Sarge.
My name is Butch, and I can lick any guy in the gang except maybe Bazooka Joe.
Boy, do I love to eat. That's why the kids in Bazooka Joe call me Hungry Herman. Oh. Lil Pat's my name, and my big sister is Bazooka Joe's girlfriend. Get your shooting irons ready, partner. I'm Bazooka Joe, kid's brother, and I'm coming your way in Bazooka Comics. My name's really Orville, but all the kids call me Pesty. And here's the dog. Bazooka Joe's dog, Walkie Talkie. I think I've covered all the characters. Now let's get into the linen backing of this piece. This sheet has cleaner edges make it easier for me. I've opened the window and you can hear all the ambulances outside. New York keeps its cops busy because we keep letting the criminals out of jail. That way, leaving more time for Letitia James to go after Trump for his crimes against humanity. Nine out of ten, they already chased down that guy yesterday. But this thin paper really absorbs quickly and evenly. As the paper expands, it bunches up, so I've got to sort of pull it apart so that it expands properly and stretches out into its proper position all around. Stretched out really well, quickly, better than the first one.
In 2012, Bazooka Candy Brands announced they would no longer include comics, instead using brain-teasing puzzle wrappers in an attempt to modernize the brand. In Argentina, sales continue with the comics in Spanish using the name Yo Amo Bazooka. I love Bazooka. Tops lists all information about all of its Bazooka candy brands through its website, Candy Mania. In April 2019, the company announced the launch of the Bazooka Throwback Pack, which is probably going to resemble the original gum with the comic strips, I assume. Thank you to Wikipedia. Okay, we've got the 1954 sheet backed, along with the 1955 one in the background, and we're going to let these pieces dry for a couple of days before we trim them down. So, if you want to see them trimmed down, stay tuned. The customer who gave us these sheets to Linenback has also published a book through Tops about Bazooka Joe. Cover looks like the bubblegum. Here are the plates. Nice graphics, vintage graphics. And then it reprints the comic strip, the premiere frame, and all the characters' introductions. It's quite a book. And then here is a contents of articles in the book, history. Creators were. So, published by Tops in 2013.
A few days have passed, these pieces are dry, and it's time to trim them down, 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 down. Thank you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed watching me linen back these two uncut sheets. And if you've got any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, vintage paper, maps, whatever you have, get in touch with me. Tell me about what you have. Tell me its size. Tell me its condition. And send me a few photos, and I'll get back to you with a price for restoration. I look forward to seeing what you have to send me. And remember, at Poster Fix, we love to bring your paper ephemera back to life.